on. Were you reading a magazine?
No. I don't see why it's such a big deal.
You know it's not right.
You're the older sister, Emma. You're supposed to set an example.
I'm trying. Trying.
Just saying hello.
To an Englisher? You have Jacob to say hello to now.
Yes, and he would say, hello, Emma.
How are you today?
I hope you are well. I, too, am well. Such lovely weather we're having today, wouldn't you say?
You're lucky he has feelings for you. Jacob is a good man.
Well, I hope you find such a man for yourself one day, Abby. Coming, ma'am.
Hi, ma'am.
A lady's imagination is very rapid. It jumps from admiration to love, from love to matrimony in a moment. There is a stubbornness about me that never can bear to be frightened at the will of others. My courage always rises at every attempt to intimidate me.
Emma, Mr. Doe?
Yeah, Dad?
It's late. Your mom will wonder what's become of you.
Sorry, Dad, I lost track of time. I'll come in now.
You're not a little girl anymore, Emma. You don't have to sneak down here to read your book.
You knew about that?
I know my daughter.
Well, you never said anything.
Then what should I say? That you must behave the same as your sister. I have known since you were very young that you are different.
I try to fit in, Dad. To be like everyone else, I really do. I don't know what's wrong with me.
Different is nothing to be ashamed of, Em. Different is different. You cannot be who you are not. We are blessed with a wonderful life. And before long, God willing, yours will be even better when Jacob asks you to be his wife.
I don't know if I want to marry Jacob. Even if he asks, what should I do, Dad?
Your cousin, Lydia Ann, has written us a letter.
How is she?
She wants someone to come to Charm to work on the farm. It's the top of the tourist season. You would be doing her a great kindness to travel to Ohio and work by her side.
And leave Shipshawana?
I look at you a minute like you're about to burst. Always questions. Always doubts. This is not the life I wish for you.
I'll be so far away from you and Mom and Abby.
What answers you find there, I know not. But perhaps the journey will help you reach a very important decision. We will pray for your safe return.
Thank you, Dad.
And what of Jacob Yoder?
Jacob.
Hello, Emma. How are you today? I hope you are well.
I am well, Jacob. And you?
I too am well. Thank you for asking. Such lovely weather we've been having, wouldn't you say?
Yes, it's very lovely. Bye, Jacob. We need to talk.
I don't understand. Doubts. About what?
Everything.
About me? Why didn't you tell me?
Because I thought it would go away. But it hasn't, and I feel that it never will unless I do something about it.
So you're leaving?
Just for the fall, to help my cousin Charm, and to have time to think.
I have something I wish to tell you, too.
What is it?
I have decided to join the church.
Jacob, I'm so happy for you.
When I do, I will be ready to take a wife, and she too must be a member of the church.
Yes.
You know how I feel about you, Emma. We could have a good life here. Build a house, raise a family.
Jacob,
I believe in you, Emma. You're a smart girl. You will make the right decision. Have a pleasant journey.
Thank you. Emma? Emma Miller, Lydia Ann's cousin?
Yes, I'm Emma.
Hi, I'm Noah Weaver. She asked me to meet you here. How was your trip?
It was fine, thank you.
Good. Take these you and give you a ride to the farm.
Thank you.
This way. First visit to Charm?
I came once with my family, but it was a really long time ago.
Probably hasn't changed much, except for the tourists. Seem to be more each year.
That's why I came, to help my cousin with her farm during the busy season.
It's very kind of you. You know, I could show you around town if you'd like. Help you get a lay of the land.
Well, thank you, but I like to find my own way.
As you wish.
So you a friend of Lydia Ann's?
Levi, her husband, is my cousin. More like a brother, really.
Must have been really hard for you when he passed.
Yeah, it was quite a bit harder for Lydia Ann and Mary. Their farm's bigger than most, so I try to help out as much as I can.
Well, that's very kind of you. Something for you. Go.
Oh. I'll call her Molly.
Oh, that's a good name. You just made a friend for life. Welcome, Emma. It's so good to see you.
You too. Oh, and I have something for you as well.
I make it myself.
It's goat cheese.
Very unique. I'm impressed. I have dinner prepared. You both must be hungry from your journey. Come on inside, Noah. Please join us.
That's very kind. Thank you.
A person may be proud without being vain. Pride relates more to our opinion of ourselves. Vanity to what we would have others think of us.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Why not?
It's almost dark. It might strain your eyes.
Oh. Well, I'm fine. Thank you.
Pride and Prejudice. Elizabeth and Mr. Darcy. Though, I prefer her first novel, Sense and Sensibility. You know it?
No, I don't.
The vivid contrast between Eleanor and her younger sister. Reason and restraint versus passion and spontaneity. It's quite intriguing. There's a copy at the library, right downtown. I'd be happy to show you.
I think I can find it myself, but... Thank you.
Right. Well, good night then, Emma.
you all right?
Yeah. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to startle you.
No, I'm sorry too.
Here's your picture phone.
Thanks.
It's a lovely picture. Is that your boyfriend?
The day he asked me to marry him.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Oh, no, no, I called it off. It's over. He doesn't get it.
Oh. Well, says he still loves you.
Thanks. High school, college, our parents, all of our friends, everyone kept saying how perfect we were together. Sometimes I wonder if that's why he asked me to marry him in the first place, because he thought he should. I'm sorry, I don't even know you, and I'm just rambling.
No, 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 it's okay. I get it. It's hard to argue, and everyone thinks they know what's best for you.
I know, right?
I'm Emma Miller.
Kelly Bennett.
Oh, nice to meet you, Kelly.
Me too.
She found that an event to which she had been looking with impatient desire did not bring all the satisfaction she had promised herself. I am convinced it is very common indeed that very few of us do not cherish a feeling of self-complacency on the score of some quality or other, real or imaginary. It sometimes is a disadvantage to be so very guarded. If a woman conceals her affection from the object of it, she may lose the opportunity of fixing him. In vain I have struggled. It will not do. My feelings will no longer be repressed.
How did they get out?
Come on, kids! Let's go!
This way? Come on!
I don't know why this keeps happening. Come on!
The goat.
The goat.
You're okay?
Yes, it's not my first time wrestling goats.
Well, thank you for the help.
You're welcome.
You know, Lydia Ann gave me a sample of the cheese you made from these little brutes. It was really good.
Oh, well, thank you.
I've never tasted anything quite like it. She said it was because you had some secret ingredient.
It's not really a secret. I just don't tell anybody.
Well, you know, you should enter into the cheese auction at the Autumn Fest.
Yeah, I saw the sign for that in town.
You know, last year a single block sold for $100.
That's a lot of money.
So good, I can't help but wonder if there's someone back in Shipshewana who's missing your secret ingredient.
Why would you think that?
Because I know I would.
Well, even if there was someone waiting for me, if that's even what you're asking, it wouldn't really matter because I do as I choose.
So you said.
Well, now you know.
So what is it you choose?
Excuse me?
I mean, you said you do as you choose, so what do you choose? I mean, when you close your eyes, what do you see? Where do you go? What do you want?
Different. I want different.
So is that what brings you to Charm? To your cousin's farm?
Yes. But...
But it's not quite different enough.
I want to see the ocean.
I think it's important to see both worlds. The English and the Amish. Know what's out there.
And you've done that? Seen both?
This is where I belong.
My cousin's farm. It's just another mile or two down the road.
A mile? Come on, I'll give you a ride.
Oh, no, I don't want to trouble you.
Girl, it is no trouble at all. I mean, if you're allowed, are you allowed to get in the car?
Yeah. Must be so nice just to get in your car anytime you feel like it and just go wherever you want.
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Have you ever been to the ocean?
Yeah, my family has a place we go every summer.
I read in a book once that the sound of the waves and the smell of the salt water, there's nothing like it. If I could drive, that's where I'd go.
But you can. You should totally go.
What?
Yeah, you could get a ticket online to Miami tonight and be drinking, you know, Mai Tais tomorrow on the beach.
Drinking my what?
Mai Tais. Never mind.
Oh my gosh, me on a plane to Miami. This is the furthest I've ever been from Shipshewana.
Oh, so you're not from Charm?
No. No, I'm only here for the fall helping my cousin with her produce stand.
Oh. I'm in town doing the same thing. I'm helping out at the library and my aunt's place. She's got a bed and breakfast.
We came a very long way to meet.
Maybe we have more in common than we think.
Yeah.
Wow, look at this place. Someone has a serious green thumb.
In smallest space, a fruit tree place. Attended well, have fruit to sell.
What's that?
An old Amish proverb. It means make the most of what you got. This is Kelly Bennett. She gave me a ride home from town. And this is my cousin, Lydia Ann Plank.
Your aunt is Irene Abbott.
Yeah.
I deliver my cheese to her inn. Her cheese, I should say.
Wait, Emma, that's your cheese?
Oh, thank you.
It's amazing. The guests keep asking where they can find it.
Oh, well, now you know. more customers. Nice to meet you, Kelly.
You too. Come on, I'll show you around.
Great.
Cheese girl, huh? It's amazing.
Well, thank you.
Whoa.
Well, you won't be getting out of there again.
Uh-huh. That's what you said last time.
Hey.
Noah, this is Kelly Bennett. Kelly, this is Noah Weaver.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey. Kelly works at the library.
Huh. Yeah. Well, this one's blazing through the romance section like it was... Nobody cares about that.
Oh, I've got something for you.
For me?
Mm-hmm. Close your eyes.
What?
Go on.
She's not Lolly.
It's not ridiculous, it's a gift.
Noah.
Emma.
Come on. Okay, fine.
Turn around.
What is that?
What does it sound like?
Like a roar. Like it's alive.
It is alive.
But it's not an animal.
No.
Okay, what is it?
It's for you. It's the ocean.
So, what's the deal there?
What do you mean?
Noah. Husband, boyfriend.
Lydia Ann's husband died last year. That was Noah's cousin, and they were very close. He helps out at the farm whenever he can.
Oh.
He's a good man.
He's probably good at a couple things.
Kelly!
Oh, come on, like you haven't thought it.
Oh, my gosh. I could never think of him in that way.
Well, I'm pretty sure he thinks about you in that way.
Oh, no, don't be silly.
Oh, there's nothing silly about a guy holding a seashell to your ear.
It's a long story. It's hard to explain.
Yeah, well, if I ever met a guy like that, maybe my life would be different.
There's a verse in the Bible that says, "Come out from among them, and ye be separate, saith the Lord." The way we see it, the best way to avoid temptation is to isolate ourselves from the rest of society.
Temptation?
Anyone who isn't Amish.
Oh, so they're not too crazy about you hanging out with me.
My whole life, I have felt like the Englisher, an outsider. I love my home and my family, but the clothes I wear and the things that I'm drawn to, I just want more color in my life.
That doesn't sound like too much to ask.
It's like asking for the world. And now, I must decide.
Decide what?
I didn't just come to Charm to help my cousin. I came because now is a time when I have to choose which path to follow.
I've taken a lot of wrong turns in my life. It's all part of growing up.
No. The Amish faith isn't like that. It's strict. We're given a choice. I can choose whether to join the church, marry an Amish man, and follow our laws for the rest of my life. Or I can go out into the world and try and find my way there. But if I do that, my path might be set. It's much harder to come back.
Emma, come in here. I could use some help.
So how's your first week at the library?
It was great. You know, everybody's been so nice. I met this Amish girl. It's very sweet. She's seriously into Jane Austen.
That doesn't sound very Amish.
Yeah, I have a feeling she's going through something. It's nice, though, having a conversation with someone who's not constantly updating their Instagram every 10 seconds.
See there? You were so worried about leaving the city. Missing your friends.
Yeah. This place is definitely growing on me.
That's how life works. Take a new direction, you make new friends. You just have to be open.
It'd be a lot easier if Nick would stop texting me. He just won't leave me alone.
You need to stop worrying about him. The best thing you ever did was get that meathead out of your life. I know it's hard now, honey. But it'll get better. I promise.
I hope so.
There's something special here for everyone. I hope it finds you.
Englisher. How'd you meet her? Oh, she lost her phone. I found it and we started talking.
I can't imagine what you have to talk about. Do you plan on seeing her again?
I don't know. Maybe.
Yeah.
Look, Kelly is really nice. You know her aunt.
To sell my cheese, you must not forget who you are. This is how it begins.
How what begins?
I know more about these things than you think, Emma. Mixing the two worlds. I've seen this before with someone else very close to me.
What? Who? Who?
That is not for me to say. What I will say is you must not make the same mistake.
What are you talking about?
I set out more of your cheese samples today, and they sold out in an hour. You must make more for tomorrow.
Noah thinks I should enter in the Autumn Fest cheese auction.
Noah is a wise man. It may fetch a good price. Good money for your dad and family back home.
Of course.
Had I been in love, I could not have been more wretchedly blind, but vanity, not love, has been my folly.
you're quiet this morning.
I can sing if you'd like. What's your favorite hymn?
Oh, right.
I'm joking. You know, when I used to work in the fields, I'd look up at the passing planes all day, wondering where people were going, what I was missing out on. So I finally went searching for my own answers. See new places.
But you came back.
I mean, you spend your entire life looking for something you believe must be out there, the one thing that'll answer all your doubts and fears. But in the end, the answer I found was right here all along.
But that was you. I don't know yet what's right for me.
I'm only sharing this with you, Emma, to spare you from all the time I lost. All the dead ends.
I don't want to be spared, Noah. I want to see the world for myself. To make my own choices.
I truly hope you find what makes you happy.
It's not too far. We'll help you get directions when you get inside, and you'll move great. All right, so have fun.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Morning, Mrs. Abbott. How are you today?
Just dandy, thank you. And you must be Emma. Kelly tells me you two hit it off at the library.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like I already know you.
You do?
Well, between everything Kelly's told me and that wonderful cheese of yours.
Oh, well, thank you.
I hope you brought more.
Sure did.
Wonderful.
Hey, is Kelly here?
She's around back. I'm sure she'll be happy to see you.
Look. I'm sorry for just surprising you like this and all the calls and texts, but I had to talk to you.
Nick, I want you to leave.
Please, give me a chance.
No, there's no more chances. We're done.
You're the only one I care about. The only one I love.
Yeah, we both know that's not true.
It's different this time. I'm different.
I trusted you. You humiliated me. Everyone knows. I don't want to be with you. I came here to get away from you and all of that.
You can't be serious. This place is in the middle of the boonies. There's nothing here for you.
Actually, there is. I really like it here. I like my friends. I like the people that I'm around. I like how I feel. And you're not a part of that.
Come on, go.
Nick, stop!
I drove all the way out here. The least you can do is spend a little time.
Let go of my arm.
Why are you gonna be so difficult, Kelly?
Kelly! There you are.
We're kind of in the middle of something here.
I'm Emma. I'm a friend of Kelly's.
Hi, I'm Nick. I don't care.
Nick, stop.
I'm not done here.
Nick, you're hurting my arm.
Stop it.
Stay out of this.
Come on, let go of me.
You okay here, Emma?
Great, another one.
Let go of her arm.
Or what? Nice life with your new friends, Kelly.
You okay?
Yeah. I'm so sorry, Chris.
Got an idea. Come on.
Thank you.
Excuse me, can you get to Charm on this road?
Oh, yeah, just go 2 miles straight ahead.
Thanks. By the way, I kind of ate all your cheese samples.
That's okay.
This isn't going to be in the auction at the festival tomorrow, is it?
Yeah. Yes. Yes, it will be.
Did you make it?
I did.
Well, it's exquisite. Just like its maker.
You shouldn't say such things.
No?
Nope.
Even if it's true?
You don't even know me.
What's your name?
Emma Miller.
Emma Miller. Andy Nevins. I'm the editor for Wine, Cheese, and Dining, one of the biggest food blogs on the internet.
Well, I can't say I spend a lot of time on the computer, so.
Right. Sorry. Well, we've never done a story on the Amish and their cheese before. Would you possibly have time for an interview?
Do you want to interview me?
Yeah. We could meet at the pavilion before the auction tomorrow. Say, what, 2 o'clock?
I don't know.
Emma, I have traveled all over the world, and I've eaten at the best restaurants, and I am telling you, it would be a crime to keep your cheese a secret.
You're teasing.
You want to bet?
You're busy. This is my number. Call me. I'm staying in town. We can... You don't have a phone, do you?
No.
Okay, forget that. Let's just meet up tomorrow before the auction.
Okay.
Okay. It's a date.
Is that your batch for the auction?
Yes, I'm trying not to think about it. Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
When you met Levi, did you know right away that he was the one?
What I knew was that he was the first person I wanted to go to tell things. And that he always was interested in what I had to say. That he was my best friend.
I can't even imagine how hard it is to find love and then lose it.
Hard, yes. But I was blessed to have Levi for as long as I did. Is this about the time you've been spending with the Englisher?
No, it's not her. It's me. I need to figure out why I feel the way that I do.
Well, then we'll talk. And we'll pray. And with God's help, you'll find your answer.
But what if God's answer takes me away from everything that I know?
Then that is his will too.
Year's Autumn Festival. We have a lot of exciting events coming up today you don't want to miss, starting with everyone's favorite, the Pumpkin Slingshot Competition. Also on the main stage later today, our world-class cheese auction gets underway. Up next on the main stage, the action-packed Woolly Worm Races.
Mom, can I race the woolly worms?
First, I have to deliver our cheese for the auction.
I can take her.
Thank you, Noah.
Would you like to join us?
Sure, thank you.
Okay, so what are you going to name your worm?
Zoomy.
And they're off. In lane one, Cracker Jack is still making up for a slow
start. Come on,
Ray! In lane two, Zoomy is starting to make a move. And Blaze of Fire is
on,
pulling on to first position. Now a funny lady is back.
Looking for someone?
No. I was just taking it all in.
Come on, May!
Thank you for the book, by the way.
You're welcome. I hope you enjoy it.
You know, what I really like about her writing is...
Hey.
Hey, Andy.
You ready?
Sure. Yeah, excuse me.
I'll bring her right back.
Come on, Mary!
This is the best part of my job. Finding a place with an interesting story to tell. An autumn festival in the middle of nowhere. A beautiful Amish girl who could easily be the next big thing.
You say things.
And you're blushing.
No, I'm not.
Yep.
No, but it's just cheese.
Emma, it's more than that. It's unique.
Do you really think so?
I know so. I also know every restaurant in Manhattan will be lining up to place an order.
Manhattan?
I'm assuming you've never been there.
No.
Okay. The energy, it's magical. It's unbelievable. It's a little noisy, but you'd get used to that. And with me to show you around, I promise you, you'd love it.
That sounds so exciting.
Frank Miller, Clayton Park, and Noah Weaver, please report to the competition arena.
Did he say Noah Weaver? Come on.
Who's Noah?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this year's Lumberjack Competition. Our top prize today is a $200 cash prize to the man who can chop one of these logs in two with the least amount of strikes.
I didn't know he was going to be in there.
Let's have our contestants take their positions. First contestant on your mark.
He's just a friend. The auction, I have to go.
Wait. What about the interview? Tomorrow night, Ferris wheel, 8 o'clock?
Okay, yeah. It's a date.
exist. Nice work.
35 to 35. Let's call here. 35 to 35. 35. Going once and going twice. So $35. Well, thank you, Lydia Ann. Please do make proper settlement with the cashiers in the cashier's window there.
Thank you.
Now, folks, it's my understanding that we have a newcomer to our town and to our auction. Please welcome Emma Miller. Emma, what have you brought for us today?
I have a pound of Chev, which is goat cheese. It's a recipe from my hometown in Shipshawana.
Alrighty, well, that sounds yummy, guys. The auction's on here. Hip a 25 and 25, cheap at the 25 and 10, but 5, hip a $5, cheap 5 and 10. Hip a 5 and 10, 10, 10, cheap at the 10, but $10, ding, ding, cheap at the 10. You say 10, 15, cheap at the 10, 15, cheap at the 10, 15, now 20. And 20 is all to the 15 to 20, cheap at the 20 is all to the 20, not a ding, ding, 20. And 20 now 5, cheap at the 20, but 5, cheap at the 20, but 5, cheap at the 25, yes, 25, and 30. Hip a 30 is all to the 25, and 30 is cheap at the 25, and 30. Hip a 30, cheap at the 25, 30 now, 30 now 5. Hip a 35, cheap at the 30, but 5, cheap at the 35. Last call here, 35, cheap at the 30, but 5, going once, going twice.
50.
50 and 75 and 75, cheap at the 5. Hip a 75, cheap at the 75, not a ding, ding, cheap at the 75, cheap at the 5. Hip a 75, cheap at the 75, cheap at the 5, but 75. 75. Looks like you got competition, partner. And one's on one, cheap at the 1, but 1, cheap at the 100. Now, quarter 125, cheap at the 125. Hip at 125, cheap at the 125. Hip at 125, cheap at the 125, not a ding, ding, cheap at the 125.
$200.
$200? He must know something about this cheese if we don't, partner. 200 and a quarter, and 225, and 225, sound of the 225. 5 of the 225,
500.
500, and 5 and a quarter, and 525, and 525. If a 525, either the 25, either the 525, either the 25, either the 525. If a 25, either the 525, ding, 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 either the 525, either the 25. Last call here, 525. Going once and going twice at 525, either the 525. So, $500. We just set a record. Congratulations. Emma, thank you very much. And you can go to the cashier's room and collect your proceeds.
I could not be happy with a man whose taste did not in every point coincide with my own. He must enter in all of my feelings. The same books, the same music must charm us both. Next to being married, a girl likes being crossed in love a little now and again.
Morning.
Morning. Oh, thank you.
Mary's not feeling well.
What's wrong?
She's got a fever. Lydia asked me to help watch over.
I can handle the customers. Whatever you need. Miss Englisher. The auction?
His name is Andy.
You don't know anything about him.
Neither do you.
I know more than you think.
So that's supposed to be enough for me? What others say? What others know?
I've seen these people out there in the world. They're different.
And maybe so am I. So you have Jacob, Noah, and Andy. A lot of men in your life. How did you know when you were in love?
That was such a long time ago. To tell you the truth, Nick and I spent most of our time together out of love. I was just too busy to notice.
Busy?
Trying to keep everyone happy, pretending like everything was perfect.
What happened between you two, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, my school had a study abroad program. So I spent last summer in London, traveled all around Europe until I came home and started hearing stories from a lot of people about Nick.
What kind of stories?
That he was cheating on me while I was away. It wasn't the first time either. That's why I ended up calling off the engagement. When I told him I wasn't changing my mind, he got so angry. That's when I knew I had to get away. Away from him, away from everything that reminded me of him. Somewhere I could start over.
So you came to Charm.
Yeah, between working for my aunt, my job at the library, I get by and have enough time to think about where I'm going, what I'm doing, my next chapter.
I will pray for you to find happiness.
I don't know if that will work for me. It's been so long.
Now is the best time to start. I saw in a magazine once these pink high-heeled sandals with little diamonds all over the top.
Flashy.
Yeah. Her toes were painted pink to match, and she had this cute little ring on her pinky toe.
So I'm guessing you weren't reading Amish Vogue, right? What were you reading?
Oh, I got caught.
All right, girl. All right. You want some more color in your life?
I got you.
What are the odds that we'd be the same size? It's a sign. You have to try them.
My family would not approve.
Well, I won't tell.
Clothes must be plain, so as not to draw attention.
They're just shoes, not a prom dress. Come on.
Do this.
It's a fashion secret handed down by women from generation to generation. Try to relax.
My feet look so different.
Good different or bad different?
Good. Definitely good.
Oh my gosh, I just thought of the hottest jeans that will go perfect with those shoes.
Oh, no, no, don't even joke. Come on, just try them.
Now's the best time to start.
Who is that?
I don't know.
Going on? Mary has the chicken pox.
Mrs. Beasley says we caught it before she has any spots, but she'll be contagious for at least a week.
I called your mom and Dot. They said you never had it as a child. It gets more dangerous as you grow older, Emma. You must go home.
What? I'm not ready to go back. Not yet.
We can't take a chance on you getting sick, too.
I can see if Irma Miller has a room.
What if you stay with me at the inn?
Really?
Nine. No.
Why? There's nothing wrong with it.
There's everything wrong with it. What would I say to your parents?
Tell them that you still need my help.
No, no, this is all too much.
Let her go.
But Noah.
It's her choice.
Grab your things before we go.
Different is different. You cannot be who you are not.
It must be so wonderful to travel, to write about all the things that you see, all the exciting places.
Yes and no. They're not all exciting.
What? No, no, don't say that. I've read about them in my books, and they're beautiful and amazing and wonderful.
You're right. The world is beautiful and amazing and wonderful.
And every once in a while, you come across something that absolutely takes your breath away.
Yeah? Like what?
Last summer, I was in Rome, standing in front of the Trevi Fountain, which is one of the most romantic places in the world. It was a perfect summer night.
But I was alone. So I took a coin, made a wish, threw it into the fountain.
Well, what was your wish?
You're not supposed to say, otherwise it won't come true.
Okay.
Well, I guess I don't have to worry about that anymore.
Why's that?
Because it just came true. Right here. Right now.
You're silly.
Emma,
If you'll let me, I want to show you all those places you read about in your books.
You make it sound so simple.
It is.
Not for me.
Well, in the meantime, let's try the next best thing.
What do you mean?
Let's see if we can find a little bit of the world right here in Charm.
What?
Ah, perfect. Come on.
Oh, here we go. Enjoy.
Thank you. Courtesy of Greece, the cradle of Western civilization, and home to the greatest contribution to carnival food in the history of forever.
Okay. What is it?
This is a euro. I'm warning you, that's about to change your life.
Okay. You just eat the whole thing? It's delicious.
See what you've been missing?
There's so much in this world that I don't know about. There's so many things that I want to see and that I want to do. I just want to do it all.
I know. You will.
Thank you.
Well, hurry up. We got some work to do.
Okay. Aren't you gonna eat too?
Yes.
Oh, I have been missing out. What? Why is yours different?
It's better.
Oh, no, I didn't like it, that one. Let me taste yours.
So the guy at the auction said there was a secret ingredient in your cheese. You care to let us in on it?
Well, I just add a little honey.
Just honey?
Mm-hmm. Well, my neighbor in Shipshawana had a hive, and so normally I would get it there, but here I just go to the market.
Okay, so the honey's organic, locally grown. Like an old Amish family recipe that's been passed down?
No, actually, the first time it was an accident. I knocked over the jar of honey.
Oh, but now? I mean, it's a family recipe now. You're probably going to pass it down, so.
Well, yes, but that kind of makes it sound like my mom or my grandmother.
Emma, what we're doing here is we're creating a hook. Something that's going to draw the reader in.
You know what I'm saying?
But it's not true.
You want people to read the story.
Yes.
So sometimes you got to fudge a little on the details. I mean, who's it really going to hurt? The point is, you make a really great cheese.
I should know. Paid enough for it. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now that work's out of the way, can I ask you a question?
Another question?
Yes. Before I head back to Manhattan, will you have dinner with me? Like a real dinner?
You want to have dinner with me?
Yeah. We could do it at the inn where you're staying if it makes it easier. I mean, unless, of course, you're busy.
No, I'm not busy.
Good. Then it's a date.
It's a date. Sweetheart, you have a phone call. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Hello?
Emma.
It's Abby. Abby, it's so good to hear your voice. How are you? How's Mom and Dad?
Everything's fine. Emma, there's something I have to tell you.
What is it? What's wrong?
Nothing. I've never been happier. I just hope you can be happy for me.
And
and so are you happy for her?
Of course. Jacob is a good man, and he will be a good husband to Abby.
So, no regrets?
I have love for Jacob, like you would a brother. Not the kind of love a man and woman have if they plan to marry. Although I should have seen this coming. All those times Abby reminding me how lucky I was to have him in my life. Is it wrong to feel so relieved?
What? That you didn't marry the wrong guy?
It's not just that. I mean, my whole life, I have tried to follow the rules and to behave the way that I should. And now, for the first time, it's as if I'm free to make my own choices.
Well, is that what you want? To be free?
Well, I would like to know how it feels.
All right. Let me know when we're starting.
Well, I have a date tonight.
But I'm sorry, what?
I have a date.
You have a date with who?
Andy.
You have a date tonight with an Englisher.
Yeah, I guess so.
How did I not know about this? We have to go. We have to go, like, right now. Come on.
Go.
I'm gonna be back tomorrow.
Okay,
let's go.
Bye.
You must be Andy.
Yeah.
Follow me. Right this way. Here you go. She'll be right out.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
You look incredible.
Thank you.
Here.
Oh. Oh my gosh, that's so pretty. Oh, thank you.
Where'd you get that dress?
Oh, I just pulled it out of my suitcase.
Oh, yeah?
Hey there. Guys, ready to order?
Do you mind if I order for us?
No, please do.
We'll have the salmon with the baby potatoes and the kale salad with the champagne vinaigrette.
Great.
And I'll have a glass of the burgundy.
You got it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you want a glass of wine?
No, thank you. I don't drink.
I'll just bring you some water.
That's a first. A slice of pie lasting more than 5 seconds within your reach. Does your stomach hurt?
Everything hurts.
When I lost Levi, the only thing that got me through the pain was hearing his voice every day. Telling me to be happy. True love provides eternal happiness. True love is a gift from God.
It's not always easy. Sometimes it hurts. But if it's truly what your heart desires, you have to fight for it.
I gotta be honest, I don't really have time for books.
You have to read it. It is so good. It's Pride and Prejudice, and it's about Elizabeth Bennet and Mr. Darcy, and at first they don't really like each other.
Oh, wait, I've heard of this. They made a movie about it a while back with, what's her name? She was in that chick flick,
Sorry, I don't really know movies.
Honestly, you're not missing much with all the garbage they're putting out there these days. We should become Amish, that way you wouldn't have to watch.
Here you go. Oh,
thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you sure you don't want to sip? It's delicious.
No, I'm okay. Thank you. So, how about your family? Your mother and father?
They're back in California. I haven't seen them in about 5 years now.
5 years? You must miss them so much.
You don't know my family.
So you choose not to see them? You could, but you don't.
My old man and I haven't gotten along since I was a kid.
But he's your father, so you still respect him, yes?
The only thing I respect about him is he's got more money than God.
God doesn't have money.
I mean, he's rich, Emma. Really rich. And back before we started butting heads, he put a big chunk of that into a trust fund for me, which I came into last year.
I thought you were a writer.
It's the only catch. Gotta keep some sort of job. My old man owns the company that owns the company that owns the magazine. So.
So you respect the money?
I respect what the money can do. Because if you have enough of it, you don't have to worry about what anybody thinks. Not even your family. Especially not your family.
To have a family is a great blessing.
Well, like you said, we come from different worlds, right?
Yes, we do.
Hey, what are we doing talking about this stuff anyway? We're gonna miss the fireworks.
Miss what?
Yeah, the closing night of the festival, the grand finale. I talked to this guy and he told me this great place where we can watch the whole show. Come on.
You know, I should probably tell Kelly, or we can just stay here.
It's fun. We'll be back before you know it. Come on.
Okay.
Emma? Hey, Noah.
Hey, is Emma here?
Isn't this amazing?
It's so pretty.
Here.
On the car?
Yeah, it's a rental.
You're getting on the car?
Yeah, on the car, come on.
Oh my gosh. It is so beautiful.
You're the most beautiful.
Oh, look at that.
I like that one.
She just left.
Sandy?
But I'm sure they'll be right back.
Yeah. Thanks, Kelly.
I'll tell you, stop by.
Please don't.
You love it?
Yeah. I love it.
Hey. It's okay. It's just a kiss. Don't be nervous. You said
please.
You wanted to try new things, right?
Yeah, please stop.
It's just a kiss.
Andy, please don't.
Andy, please stop.
What's your problem, Emma? You show up dressed like that and you're telling me this isn't what you wanted?
No, never.
Really? Well, I got news for you. You say you want to see the world? Take a good look. Because this is what people do.
This is not my world.
What happened?
Yes.
You want to talk about it?
Yes, I do, but right now, I just need to go.
I'll take you to Lydia's.
Thank you, but I need to go home.
So you made your decision.
I have.
And?
Everyone said that they had faith in me to make the right choices. But what I really needed was faith in myself. Faith that I would know the answers when they came. Sometimes, God willing, we find our answers in another. Someone who is the first person that we want to go to tell things. Someone who's always interested in what we have to say. Someone who's our best friend.
She's okay. Daddy's to Papa.
Hi. Good morning. Hey,
good morning.
How's my little baby girl doing?
Oh, she's so good. Just woke up.
Oh.
Always smiling.
Oh my gosh, she's gorgeous.
So how are things at the inn?
Great. They're great. Except we keep running out of Emma Shev. We're having orders from New York, Canada. I mean, it's just...
It's the best. It's the best cheese
Not
ever.
Not bad for two girls in the boonies, eh?
Not bad at all.
Not bad at all. That's right. That's right. That's right.
So sweet. She looks like Noah.
Yeah.
Where is he, by the way?